And welcome to the eighth part of the tutorial, and today it's gonna be about the boom and zoom fighters. Okay, as a quick explanation again, what are boom and zoom fighters? Boom and zoom fighters are fighters with a high airspeed, good altitude performance, but not as maneuverable as, for example, turn and burn fighters. What does it mean? Well, you use your strength to your advantage. Means you always climb high and then dive into like the dogfights, damaging planes, and then also occasionally kill them. I think this video is good to show it. I'm playing here the Bf 109, German tier 5 fighter, which has exactly the specifications. It is quite fast for its tier. It's has a good armament, it has a good altitude performance and a good dive speed. Yeah, first of all, we are of course focusing the rocket base, the most important on this map besides the mining plant. And you are exceptionally good at killing heavy fighters because you have the altitude, you have the armament. You see how these defense planes are melting. And you see that I will try to maintain my altitude. The 109 has, in that configuration, I'm playing 320 mils and two 7.92mm machine guns, which is a strong armament for its tier. So now you see I'm like checking on what is going on down there, if I have a good target to dive on. At the moment there are only defense planes, but I'm mainly waiting for the enemy planes to arrive. Yeah, exactly, that P-40 for example, or that heavy fighter. And I don't bother in like turning, exactly because of that reason. You see, the P-40 just got me as a target, but I kept my boost, and that's really important. While you're diving, you don't boost normally, just you can like track, activate the boost just for a second and so on to gain somewhat more airspeed, but not too much. Okay, now my next target is definitely the P-40, who didn't pay attention to what I'm doing, and that's the really annoying playstyle about when it comes to boom and zoom, because you're engaging, disengaging, and people, if you're fast enough, they can't follow you. Now I have a bigger issue, because now I don't have the altitude, and I'm realizing this, but I'm having the boost. Okay, I'm going for quick kills or damage on planes, and then I try to run away. And yeah, once I realize that it's not going to happen, because I have a heavy fighter who's equally fast and has a good boost, I'm just going in again and try to kill at least one or two planes, and then I'm most likely going to die. Okay, I killed the Hurricane, which is good, but sadly I had not enough support by my team here. Alright, but yeah, that was that can happen sometimes. You end up in a situation where you can't get out easily, and then you have to like, if you can go for a target, then do it. But never start turn fighting with a Zero or a Spitfire. That's like always 90% where you can lose this fight. So first of all, of course, I'm trying to gain some altitude. Always have a look on what is going on below me. Here I have two low HP targets. First, I take the I-16, insta kill. The heavy fighter didn't pay attention, he's trying to turn fight for whatever reasons. The other turn heavy fighter also, they didn't keep their speed, and that now they are paying the price. Alright, this dogfight, that's not an issue. I can stay at that level because I have enough friendly planes, so I can just easily pick the targets in case it's needed. So, but as soon as this is over, I'm going in and... No! Okay, I'm going for this heavy again. Okay. But you see how quickly you melt these guys with your armament. You're really a bane to heavy fighters on this tier. Also, you wanna focus the low HP targets first. That should be doable. This is not perfect. I should have stayed. I was a bit greedy for the kill here, and tried to help my teammate or bot, team bot, whatever you wanna call it. Now I'm in the middle of everything, but it's luckily that are just air defense planes. So I'm going through it, and after the last one passed me, I'm turning. Because we just need one kill, so then we get capture point. They all die. This French fighter is way, way maneuverable than I am, so I don't bother doing it. I don't want to play in his cards, so this I want to dictate the engagement. That's really important. If you don't do that, you will suck. That's for sure. And many players make the mistake of being just too greedy, fire the guns, and they always end up in the situation with this, yeah, fighters that are meant to be boom and zoom, that they are not having enough airspeed, they can't outmaneuver or outrun anything anymore, they have no boost left, and then that's it. And that bot heavy fighter is doing exactly the same mistake. He just turned. And he, now he can't get away. I think the bot fighters or planes are just using their boost way too early, just to engage first and then not to disengage. Yeah, there's also low HP bomber. Yeah, you can easily shoot down bombers or bot bombers as well, because you have the altitude. I think this 109E is capable of climbing up to 3000 meters, so shouldn't be an issue. So now I'm 1500 meters, I'm recharging my boost, and now I'm waiting for victims. This P40 definitely could go for. And that's whenever you engage, you always check your surroundings first with every plane. We cannot support you any longer. Okay, making a loop to engage now from above. Over. To get that key. Who's like also a bot? But he's. They are just trying to chase planes, and that's not going to work in this turn and burn fighters. You can do it in a boom and zoom fighter, because you're decently fast, and you can normally, if you have a, don't waste your boost, you can just disengage. And that's mainly what I'm doing. I'm gaining my airspeed. You always want to keep the energy. Okay, killed that one as well. And I'm climbing up again. Somehow the enemy managed to regain that middle cap again. I have no clue how, but they achieved it. Always take a look behind you, what's going on. And again, gaining airspeed. Killing that ground attack. And climbing up. I see only air defense planes, so not the thing to worry the most about. Yeah, can actually kind of turn fight, because they are really not as maneuverable and not really that good. I killed that one, and now it's sadly too late. Yeah, we lost the game, but I had a really decent game with Winged Legends, which is, I think, normally worth 1 token. That's when you gain 14,000 personal points. Overall, for myself, a really successful round, but my team didn't go into line with me, so yeah, they did something else. Alright, hope you enjoyed it. Hope it helped you, and leave something in the comment if you have questions or something else. Bye-bye.